This tutorial is about modeling, UV unwrapping and rendering a simple cushion with seams and stitches. If you're a Fusion, SolidWorks or Rhino user, you can still follow the same process. Only the modeling part will be a bit different. Maybe check out the three-part overview first. Draw a profile curve and create a partial revolve surface. Sculpt the surface into shape by scaling its CVs. Move some CVs out of their hull to create indentations. Create a tubular offset for the cushion's piping. Create seams and stitches with reflected parts of the main surface. Project lines and trim off the overlapping seam surface parts. Detach, trim convert and CV snap the gaps shut. Stitch the surfaces, mesh them and export as OBJ for Maya. A surface mapping shows you why UV unwrapping is necessary. Import the fabric panel OBJ. Merge its four submeshes. At this stage, distortion and per-mesh texturing is clearly visible. Apply a planar projection along the y-axis. After UV unfolding, distortion and per-mesh texturing have disappeared. Rotate and scale the UV shell to real-world size. Import the piping and stitch OBJs. Complete the object and export the OBJs for rendering. Drag a photo studio into your scene and disable the sky or IBL environment. Import the OBJs, switch on the interactive renderer and arrange your scene. Import the materials you need and assign them to the various parts. Adjust the lens, shutter speed, f-stop and DOF and render. Open Alias and load standard beginner preferences. Set your construction tolerances to practical values. Choose a suitable grid spacing related to the size of the product. Draw a degree 5 curve in the back view. Move the CVs until you have the right profile while checking with curve curvature. Use the Revolve tool and create a 90-degree surface segment with two spans. because the CV's pivot point is at zero, which is the same of the surface they belong to, they scale symmetrically to sculpt the basic shape. Select the four center CVs at the end sections, set their pivot to the center, and scale them down by the same factor. Clean up the shape, but remember to move the CV symmetrically. Now increase the number of spans to 17 in the V direction and sculpt a few indentations into the surface. Reset the pivot point back to zero and scale the perimeter CVs into a slightly irregular outline. But don't move the first and last two, so the outline remains continuous when reflecting the surface later. With a tubular offset tool, create the cushion's piping as a single surface. Reflect copy the main surface and detach behind the first isopalm, then delete the rear parts. With adjacent surfaces, use the stitch and seam tool to create the detail you want. Almost any kind of stitch and seam style can be generated with this tool. Delete the no longer needed parts. Draw lines across the seam ends at each corner and project them onto the end surfaces. Delete the unnecessary curves on surface on the far ends before you trim. Detach the trim seam surfaces at the last isopalm, then trim convert the end snippets to regular degree 5 surfaces. Snapshot the gaps by moving the end CVs. Before stitching, meshing, and exporting, ensure that all normal vectors are pointing outwards. Measure both arc lengths of the pipe so that later you can scale its texture repeat correctly. Stitch all fabric panel surfaces and the pipe into separate solid shells. And finally, mesh the shells with a suitable tessellation. Export the three meshes as OBJ files for use in Maya. For these kind of products, you obviously need to unwrap the UVs. Open Maya and select the UV editing workspace. Activate the texture display in the viewport, so you can preview how textures change while working with the mesh's UVs. Import the panel OBJ file you exported from Alias, Fusion, SolidWorks or Rhino. The F key centers your selection in the viewport. If necessary, rotate and scale the imported mesh in the channel box. And don't forget to zero the transformations. Merge the panel's four meshes into one. Select the merged mesh, right-click and assign a Lambert material. Load a fabric texture into the material's color slot. Like in your modeling software, you see right away that without UV unwrapping, the texture is distorted and applied on a per mesh basis. If you don't have a texture loaded yet, the checker map display shows you the problem too. Create a planar projection in the UV editor and select the vertical axis, the y-axis in Maya. Take note that the UVs are no longer applied on a per mesh basis. Now you can unwrap the UVs with Unfold in the UV editor, but don't select the Layout UVs option. Deactivate the checker map display, press F8 for object mode, and deselect the object. After UV unwrapping, the fabric texture is no longer distorted. Press Alt F12 to activate the UV shell mode. Then press E to rotate and R to scale the UVs to match the real-world scale of your texture. Pressing the W key allows you to move the UV shell across the texture. The ArrowWay fabric texture used in this tutorial is 100 cm square, so either you calculate by how much the UV shell should be scaled or you eyeball it. Close the UV editor and import the pipe and stitch OBJs. Then rotate and move the meshes using the channel box as before. And again, don't forget to zero the transformations. When your imported geometry appears black, it means that its normal vectors are pointing inwards. Use Mesh Display Reverse to flip them. Rotate and reflect copy the panel and stitch meshes with Duplicate Special to complete the object. Now that you're done, it's maybe a good idea to save the file in case you need to reuse it. Select the panels and save them as OBJ file, and do the same with the pipes and stitches. Open Maxwell Studio and load a standard beginner layout through the Windows menu. Save your scene to activate the autosave feature. Drag a photo studio from the library into the viewport. Choose one that suits the size of the cushion. Activate the camera in the viewport. Unlock the camera sensor settings in the Attributes panel and set it to HD format, 1920 by 1080 pixels. Change the focal length of the lens to something suitable for product photography and then set ISO, shutter speed and f-stop for a good depth of field. Change the environment from sky to none, so only the photo studio emitters light the scene. Import all OBJs exported from Maya together. Make sure to select Rename the new one so the parts don't override each other. All parts will appear in the object list. Scale your parts to real world size. Rotate and move the parts to their initial position. With the right mouse button menu in the viewport, you can center the view and autofocus. Click Fire to start the interactive renderer. You can change fire speed and quality anytime and continue working on your scene in parallel. Maybe change some of the lights to reduce the hard shadow or make the overall lighting less flat. Import the materials needed for this particular product and choose Embed. This means the materials in your scene will be saved in the file. Drag the materials onto your parts in the viewport or the object lister. Frame the view as you like and let the interactive renderer render to a higher quality. Let's try a different look. Import a more interesting and complex material and assign as before, then reframe the view and let it render again. To output a final render, set the render options. Choose a suitable time and sampling level, and don't forget to switch on the multi-light function. Name your output files and make sure to render a 16 or 32-bit image. If you want to resume the render later, you must save the scene file, not only the image. Start the render in CPU mode, unless you have an NVIDIA graphics card as GPU. In the render app, you can see how render time and quality progress. You can change camera, tone mapping, and other settings, and you can resume existing renders to a higher quality. The multi-light feature allows you to change the lighting of your scene without having to redo the render. A new rendering is generated once you click the refresh button. You can also reset the lines to their initial values. If you made changes, save the image and MXI file. Within 30 minutes, you have a good image. And now it's your turn. Thank you for watching and listening.